Welcome to the Shining Time Station Drive-In Movie Theater. Conveniently located 1 mile past Barton Winslow's General Store and directly across the road from Jenny's Farm. Tonight's episode stars Stacy Jones, Schemer, Mr. Conductor, the kids from Shining Time, along with the Jukebox Band, and Thomas the Tank Engine. So get your ticket for another full-length adventure of Shining Time Station. While you're waiting, don't forget to visit our snack bar. We have freshly popped popcorn and plenty of it. Mmm. And you can get an ice cold drink to go along with it.
The following is a paid advertisement for Schemer's Arcade.
Schemer, 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 Schemer's Arcade. Come on down to Schemer's Arcade.
That's right, kids. Schemer wants all of you to come right down to his world-famous arcade, located in the left-hand corner of Shining Time Station. And don't forget what Schemer always says.
Spend your nickels, spend your nickels, spend them today. Spend your nickels, and just go away.
Schemer, 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 Schemer.
That's right, kids. It's games, 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 games at Schemer's Arcade.
Come on down to Schemer's Arcade.
And now, sit back and enjoy our feature presentation.
Reach for the speed, reach for the whistle, go where the rail may run. Reach for the words, reach for the story, follow the rainbow sun. To a shining time station, where dreams can come true, waiting there for you.
Hiya, Stacy.
Hiya, Dan. Would you do me a big favor? Could you please empty all the waste baskets?
Sure.
Oh, thank you, honey. Can't have Shining Time Station looking messy, huh?
Mr. Conductor, you in there? Today's garbage day.
Hi, Dan. Good, you're collecting the trash. Hold on a minute. I think I can make a contribution. And here it is. Don't go away. I've been doing a little house cleaning. Here's another one. I'm not done yet. Now, where did I put that other bag? Oh, here it is. Lots of memories in this one. But I need the room.
All this came from there?
Oh, yes.
How did it fit?
I'm very organized.
Gather around, everybody. Gather around for a Schemer Special Deluxe one-day-only event. Now, I know what you're going to be saying. You'll be saying, Schemer, have your big brain started to drip out of that genius skull of yours? Well, maybe. Because I am going to be giving away these extra good Lollapalooza Pops. Well, I know you might be saying to yourself, why, Schemer? Why?
Why are you giving them away?
Why am I giving them away for absolutely free? Well, because they're free samples. Some guy is actually paying me to give these away. And he said they're really, really good and made with extra special, healthy, artificial, natural flavors.
Well, they're wrapped really well. Yeah. It's in tinfoil.
Oh, yeah, that's to keep all the artificial, natural flavor in.
What's this? Wax paper?
Yeah, it's wax paper. That's to keep all the germs out and all the bad stuff.
Cardboard?
The cardboard. That's to keep its natural shape.
Is this plastic?
Yeah. That's probably... That's to keep the dangerous ultraviolet rays of the sun out.
Look at this. What is this?
Oh, it's hospital gauze. It's hospital gauze to keep it healthy. You know, to keep the bugs out and stuff, because if bugs could get in here, then I'm sure they'd just love it.
It's a little lollipop. It's a tiny lollipop.
No. It's a very well-wrapped, beautifully sealed for natural goodness little tiny lollipop. Mmm. Good, huh?
I guess so.
Hey, it's free.
Yeah, but look at all this wrapping. It's a lot. Where can we throw it all?
Oh, hey, stand in the garbage man. Just the guy I wanted to see.
Dad, is that all the garbage?
No, there's more out back.
Good, here. Take some of this with you, will ya?
There's no more room in here.
Come on, yeah, yeah. Hello, Miss Jones.
Oh, hello, Mr. Typo. How's the newspaper business?
Oh, just great. Couldn't be better. Top of the world. Have you seen the paper?
No, I haven't.
My story is the headline, the big news, the lead story.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, let's see. The garbage dump is closing.
Oh, pretty great, isn't it? I wrote it all myself. Searched out the facts, interviewed people, typed it all up, took careful notes, and had to look up a few words in the dictionary. And the paper printed it, and there it is.
This is terrible.
I suppose you are entitled to your opinion, Miss Jones, but I'm telling you it's some of the best writing you'll ever read in this entire valley.
Oh, no, Mr. Typo, not your writing. The fact that the garbage dump is closing, it's terrible. Where are we going to put all our garbage?
Oh, beats me. Here, I brought along lots of extra copies so you can hand them out to people.
But what are we going to do with them? I mean, we don't have any place now to throw them out.
Throw them out? No. You don't throw something out as good as this. You cherish it.
We're gonna have to stop making garbage.
Hey, I don't make garbage. I make music.
What do we do with our trash?
Trash.
Hey, we can put it in a nice box.
Yeah, and we can cover it with a nice pretty paper.
And wrap it up in ribbon.
And make it look something like this. Ain't that pretty?
Hey, did you hear? The dump is closed.
And we'll give it to Tito for his birthday. Happy birthday, Tito!
For me? You shouldn't have.
We know.
Look out now.
Let's get out of here.
Don't crowd me now.
Oh!
There's a train coming in very slowly on track 4.
Track 4? Oh! We haven't used that track in years. Let me see. No. There aren't any trains scheduled to be on it.
I'll clean up and then go out and have a look.
Oh, no, Mr. Conductor. Billy's not here today. I need you to stay and keep an eye on things. I'll go out and try to find that engineer. Hey, Mr. Baker.
Yeah, hey, kid.
What you doing?
I'm doing what I'm always doing. Searching for fresh, exciting news. The truth behind the truth. The big story.
I've got a story.
Yeah. Goldilocks got a haircut. I'm looking for real stories, kid. Not fairy tales.
But it is a real story, isn't it?
Okay. I'll bite. What's your story?
Well, you see this garbage?
Yeah.
Well, most of it came from that switch-out station in the painting.
This garbage came from that switch station in the painting, huh?
Yes.
Oh, don't tell me. There's a little man who lives in there.
Yes, you know?
Oh, sure. I know all about little men who live in pictures in the wall. That's why I'm the ace reporter for the Indian Valley Gazette.
You don't believe me.
Yeah, run along, Sonny, before little men start sitting on my hat. Sheesh, kids today, I tell you. Wait. Today's kids, nuttier than ever. Ah. Oh.
Oh, Dad, I can't find that engine.
kitchen or anywhere.
Well, I'm all done, Aunt Stacy.
Honey, where did you throw the trash?
On a train.
What train?
The one that's parked right outside that says garbage on it.
What?
Oh! Excuse me, sir. Is that your train outside?
Aye, it is.
The one marked garbage on it?
Aye.
Well, sir, I am Stacy Jones. I'm in charge of the station.
Oh, Rusty Rob McHale, chief engineer of the R&O freight line. How do you do?
Oh, how do you do, sir? Mr. McRail, may we put our trash on your train?
You might as well. Everyone else has.
Oh, that's terrific. Becky, get all those empty paint cans out of Billy's workshop. I'll grab whatever else we have to throw away. There's a train outside collecting trash.
Excuse me. Can I put my trash on your train, too?
Aye, you may.
That's my kind of train.
Aye, yourself.
What are you doing?
I'm reading a map. Complicated things maps are. Has anyone ever taught you how to read a map, lad? Well, you're a smart wee thing. How would you like to engineer a huge train? Try this on.
I can't see.
Well, that could hold you back.
Thanks for letting us throw our trash on your train.
Yes, thank you, sir. Is there anything we can do for you?
Do? No, there's nothing you can do. But you can tell me something.
What's that, sir?
You can tell me in the clearest possible manner how to get to the Indian Valley garbage dump.
Oh, sir, it's closed.
This is my lucky day. Another dump closed.
Hey, mister. Is that your train outside?
Aye.
It smells awful.
Well, so would you, miss, if you'd been stuck to the roof with garbage and sitting out in the sun for 30 days.
Have you been traveling that long?
Aye.
How did you get here?
It's a long story.
Is it a sad story?
Oh, aye. Parts of it are truly tragic. I started out far, far away with a song in my heart and a smile on my lips and a whole trainload full of dirty trash and filthy junk. And worse, half-eaten egg salad sandwiches.
Oh.
So, I chugged on down to the town dump. Not here, they said. Go away, you filthy thing. Take your trash somewhere else. So, I went down to the next dump. But place after place was closed. Lucy's Leap, Farmer's Dell, Loom Key, they were all closed.
That's awful.
Aye, it is.
Yeah.
Yes, that's terrible.
I guess you'll be moving on to another dump.
Yeah, you better get started.
Yeah, I mean, the track is all clear.
Here we have.
You know, the sooner you get going, the sooner you'll quit stinking up this joint.
Oh, well, I like that. One minute you're telling me, there, there, you dear sweet man. And the next you're giving me the boot. May we please put our trash on your train, Rusty? Why, certainly. Well, now get going with it, you stinky man. I thought you people were a bit different. But you're the same as all the others. You don't understand. There's nowhere to dump the garbage. I have nowhere to go.
Well, it's just, nobody wants a trainload of garbage sitting in their station. Look, I'll go talk to Mr. McRail. Maybe there's something that we can work out.
Well, garbage doesn't go away on its own. Someone has got to take care of it.
Yeah, but nobody likes garbage.
Yeah, except flies. They love it.
Hey. You know, if I could charge a fly a nickel every time they land on the garbage, I'd be a rich man. Hey, get over here. You owe me a nickel. There he is.
Hi, kids. What's the buzz? What are these, honeybees?
No, they're garbage flies.
Not quite the same thing, is it? I'm quite fond of honeybees, unless they try to sting me. But I haven't made up my mind about garbage flies.
Are there a lot of honeybees on the island of Sodor?
Oh, indeed there are. James had quite an experience with honeybees. I'll never forget it. Neither will he. I'll tell you all about it.
Trevor, the traction engine, was enjoying his work in the vicarage orchard. Birds were singing and apples were ripening on the trees. It was a lovely day.
Hello, Trevor, said James. You look as bright and cheerful as my red paint.
Oh, I am, replied Trevor.
What's that noise?
It's the bees, laughed Trevor. They're all in these boxy things called beehives. I'm taking them to the station. The vicar says his bees make good honey, and he's giving some of them to his friends. Just then, Boko, the diesel engine, hummed in.
Take care, you two. Don't make the bees angry. They might sting you.
James didn't like being told what to do by a diesel, and he buzzed away.
Goodbye, Trevor, called Boko, and set off to see Doc at the next station.
Bill and Ben, the tank engine twins, were busy arranging cars, but they scampered off when they saw Boko.
I remember the first time I met those two, laughed Boko. They nearly made my eyes pop out. Edward soon put a stop to their games.
Edward is the only one who can keep Bill and Ben in order, chuckled Duck. I sometimes call them the bees.
A good name, replied Boko. They're terrors when they start buzzing around.
James bustled in.
What's that, Duck? Are you afraid of bees? They're only insects, after all, so don't let that buzzbox diesel tell you different.
His name is Boko, and he didn't.
I wouldn't care if hundreds were swarming around. I'd just blow smoke and make them buzz off.
Buzz, 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 retorted Duck. The next morning, James arrived at the station to collect his coaches. The passengers were excited and keen to get on board. The platform was crowded, and the porter was in a hurry.
Mind your backs, he shouted.
Then there was trouble. The beehive fell and broke open. The station cleared like magic. James heard a familiar buzzing. The bees were too cold to be cross, so they buzzed around the fireman, hoping he'd mend their hive. But he didn't understand, nor did his driver. So the bees turned to James. His boiler was nice and warm.
Buzz off! Buzz off!
Hissed James. One bee burnt his foot.
Ooh, ooh.
The bee thought James had burnt him on purpose. So it stung James right back on the nose.
Eee!
Whistled James. He had had enough. So had his fireman and driver. They didn't notice till too late that they had left all their coaches behind. They tried everything to get rid of the bees. First they spun on the turntable, but to no avail. They tried washing them off, but the bees clung harder to James's warm boiler. Then they tried smoking them off by going through a long tunnel, but still the bees wouldn't go away.
It's no good, James, said his driver. We'll just have to go back to the orchard and fetch another hive.
James's reply was drowned by the sound of buzzing. The vicar was waiting anxiously for James. When he arrived, the bees swarmed straight into their new home.
Come on, James, said his driver. What you need now is a good hose down.
Later that evening, James was resting in the shed when the vicar came to see him.
Thank you for saving my bees, he said. It's a pity it's not Christmas. Then we could call you James the Red-Nosed Engine.
Everyone laughed, even James. But instead, they decided to call James the Bee's Knees, which means they thought he was more useful than ever.
Well, I wish these garbage flies were honeybees. I know the bees stung James, but bees only sting when they're angry. Garbage flies are dirty all the time.
Too bad this garbage couldn't just fly away.
Yeah. You see, the garbage dump is closed.
Well, remember, for every door that closes, a window opens.
Well, the windows are shut and it still smells in here.
No, that's not what Mr. Conductor means. You mean like the expression, if life gives you lemons, you make lemonade.
Exactly.
Maybe we could turn all this trash into something we can use?
Well, let's think about it. If we can't throw the garbage away, what else can we do with it? I'll tell you what. Why don't we go down the anything tunnel and maybe we'll get some ideas.
If everyone did a little,
just like you and me.
If everyone did a little,
a difference you would see.
Yes, if everyone did a little, a little, a little.
What a great world this would be. Be sure to bring back all your empty bottles. Reusing them will sure save energy. Now we really don't have to make new ones. So pick up every bottle that you see, like me.
If everyone did a little,
just like you and me.
If everyone did a little,
a difference you would see.
Yes, if everyone did a little, a little.
What a great world this would be.
Nothing smells as bad as piles of garbage. And when it stands, the odor grows and grows. When it shovels back into the ground, though, it will turn up and smell just like a rose. Who knows? If everyone helped a little,
just like you and me.
If everyone helped a little,
a difference you would see.
Yes, if everyone helped a little, a little, a little.
What a great world this would be.
If we care enough for one another,
we'll separate the trash that's thrown away.
Yes, this world will be a whole lot sweeter.
Breathe clean air each bright new day.
Okay!
If everyone cared a little, just like you and me.
If everyone cared a little,
a difference you would see.
Yes, if everyone cared a little, a little, a little. What a great world this would be.
I smell a story here.
Oh, it's a typhoid here.
Oh, that must be
the garbage drain outside has no place to go.
Garbage dump opens at Johnny Five Station.
No, Mr. Typo. We got to figure something out.
There's a story here I wrote for my school newspaper that had the Valley Railway needs a recycling center.
Let me do that. What's a recycling center?
Well, it's where all the trash gets separated. All the glass, all the cans, all the papers, and they get to be reused.
Oh, that's a great idea, Becky. Does Mr. McWhale know about recycling?
Not yet, but I'm going to tell him.
Oh, but wait a minute. Becky, we don't have a recycling center.
What is she doing?
I don't know. She definitely got something on her mind.
Calm down, Russ. Yes, let me understand you. You want to turn my train into a recycling center?
We can help you.
She's just a wee girl.
We can recycle all that garbage.
Recycle? You mean go through all that filthy trash and sort it out? Then send it to some place to make it useful again?
Yes.
You're talking about a whole train full, Russ. Do you know that?
Yes.
There's an awful lot of half-eaten egg salad sandwiches in there.
Oh! We can compost those and use them for our gardens.
Are all you people willing to do that for me?
Yes!
You're a fine bunch. Right, let's get at it then.
Mm-hmm.
savages. Forget about it. Hey, I know what I'll do. I'll play some Redikeleague music.
Oh, Skiba, would you play some Redikeleague music?
Yes, I will.
Oh, Skiba, you are so wonderful.
I know I am.
Hey, I recognize that nickel.
Garbage isn't the only thing that gets recycled.
Well, let's recycle some fine old tune and make it fresh as new.
How about...
Oh, that's a good worky song.
And a one, and a two, and a one, two, three.
Train's all loaded. Can you beat that?
Who was it?
A plastic manufacturer will pay me money for the big pile of plastic, and so will a can maker for the pile of cans.
Oh, wow, will they really turn all that back into new?
Aye, they will, and make it useful again. And I have to bring it to them. I've got a new career. I'm the new Recycle Express. I think I have you to thank for it all, young lady. You've done more good today than you know. I thank you.
Will we see you again?
Well, it's hard to say, but I do know this. Whenever you see a pile of trash that needs to be sorted and hauled somewhere nearby, I'll be there. Wish me luck.
Oh, good luck, McGrill.
Oh, just in case. What's this now? Unless I'm much mistaken, a wee person has just sorted out his trash for me. Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.
Hey, we've got to give you a recycle.
Reach for the speed, reach for the whistle, go where the rail may run. Reach for the words, reach for the story, follow the rainbow sun. To a shining time station, where dreams can come true, waiting there for you. So much to see, so far to travel, so much to learn to know. Friends by your side, hopes to hold on to, who knows how far you'll go. To to a shining time station where dreams can come true. Your own imagination waiting there for you.
The following short movie was paid for by Schemer. We had nothing to do with it.
And now, Schemer presents a series of really worthwhile buying, can't-miss inspirational video lessons that sometimes teach you stuff. Produced by Schemer, written by Schemer, directed by Schemer, and starring Schemer as himself. Taped on location in his very own room. And now, let's join me. Did I miss anything? Hey, everybody, I'm Schemer. Mwah. And this is what I call something I call Schemer Presents. Now, I hear you asking me, why? Why am I doing it? Why am I doing it? Well, let's just say that... Let's just say that I want this to be a giving world. A world in which everyone, kids, parents, and adult children of grown-up babies, everyone gives me, Schemer, money. Ow! I love it when that happens. I really do. As I always say, if you can't have a bed fall out of a wall and hit you on the head, well then, my friend, you don't belong in this business. Well, enough about me and my head. Let's look at today's lesson, okay? All right. Today's lesson is... how to get something done. Anyway, here's what I'm going to do today. I have to make a sign for Shining Time Station. Why? Because Stacy Jones, who just happens to be the manager of Shining Time Station, asked me to make a sign. So, I'm going to. Now, what do you need to make a sign? Simple. Sign-making stuff. Gonna go in my closet and get some sign-making stuff. Oh! It's just a mannequin. I mean, it's not a person, it's a dummy mannequin. You okay? Hope someone doesn't step on your stomach. Woo! Okay. Can't find that... back to that... sign-making material, but... ah, here we go. Got it. Glue. Now, this is very important for sticking things together in kind of a sticky, gluey kind of way. So if you want to get something done, remember, you got to get it done with... got to get it done with glue. I seem to be having a bit of a glue situation here, but don't worry about it. It is strictly, basically routine kind of a glue situation. That could be the phone. Hey, hello? It's my mommy. She's helping me with... that's my mommy. She's helping me with Schemer Presents. She likes to call in and make sure that everything's going okay, which it basically is. Come in, mommy! Hello? Yes, I'm about to make the sign. I just actually haven't found the sign-making stuff yet in order to make the sign that I... careful of what? Yes, I know that the glue doesn't have a top on it. I'm well aware of that fact. Okay, I'm hurrying up. Okay, bye-bye, mommy. Jeez. I know what you're saying to yourselves right now. You're saying, Schemer, you're sure under a lot of pressure with a phone stuck to your hand. But don't worry about it. Believe me, I'm somebody who just does really well under pressure. Okay, I'm gonna go back in the closet and get the rest of my glue making stuff. So just wait right where you are. Oh! Oh no! Oh no! My glue! That's my glue! Hold on. Hey, hold on! Pin!
What happened to
your hands.
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? Your hands are all covered with glue, red glitter, and feathers.
Oh, that. I thought you meant something besides that.
Have you done the sign yet?
No.
You had a whole hour! And where's the cardboard and markers?
Don't you want to know where the glue is?
Look, Schemer, anytime you have something big to do, the first thing you do is think of the best way to do it. Then you lay out all the materials you need.
Oh, that's easy for you to say, little Miss Know-It-All. But what happens if your hands happen to be covered in feathers and glitter and you can't find anything to wipe them off with?
Then you ask for help.
Well, maybe I'll do that next. Oh, okay. All right, there we go. There. There. Nothing can stop me now. My way. So, what you're saying is do everything at once.
No, Skinner, I'm saying you do it in steps. Step one, you think about the best way to do your project. Step two, you lay out your materials.
Like this?
Good. Then step three, you work on your project. What's the sign supposed to say anyway?
Well, it's supposed to say closed for repairs.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, I guess if you want something done, you ask Kara. How like can you? Listen, the real way to get something done is like this. Here we go. Hey, think about your plans and what you want to do. Make sure your hands don't get covered with glue. Then get your materials out and ask for help when you're in doubt. Do one thing at a time and blah, 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 something else that will rhyme. And so you won't be bitter. Stay away from feathers and glitter. Feathers and glitter. Stay away from feathers and glitter. That's right. Stay away from feathers and glitter. Boy, you know, there are some things only music can say. And say, oh, hey, say, that looks great.
That's how you get something done.
Yeah, and this is how I'm going to end the show. I hope to be seeing you once again, seeing me on Schemer Presents. Come on, Carol, let's go.
We hope you've enjoyed the show and that you'll come back and see us again soon. Remember to drive carefully and have a safe trip home.